And our first thing that might be a thing now is getting to understand the youth by adopting an Iraqi war orphan.
As insane as that sounds, Jonathan Franzen, the author of many fat books that win awards that I will not read, almost did just that. Adopt an Iraqi war orphan to understand young people, because everyone is just his plaything.
One of the things that had put me in mind of adoption was a sense of alienation from the younger generation. They seemed politically not the way they should be as a young people. I thought people were supposed to be idealistic and angry, and they seemed kind of cynical and not very angry. At least not in a way that was accessible to me.
Sure, it's because they're not accessible and not that you're just really ignorant. Luckily, the idea lasted about 6 weeks before his editor, Henry Finder, suggested maybe a different way of understanding young people.
Johnny, this is crazy. Let's just go down to the university, meet some co-eds. Bing, bang, boom, you understand the youth. Let's do cocaine.
Franzen now says his anger to young people has been cured because apparently all he needed was one afternoon talking to a small demographic of 20-year-olds that represent the entirety of youth and not a life commitment to some innocent orphan.
Next up, D's Nuts. Not D's Nuts. D's Nuts for president.
Currently polling in third place in several states is the presidential candidate D's Nuts, or for legal reasons, 15-year-old Brady Olson. Brady started the movement when he became disillusioned with the failed two-party system. Of course, let's not forget the long and storied history of presidential candidates having crazy running mates. John McCain and Sarah Palin.
I believe marriage is meant to be a sacred institution between two unwilling teenagers.
Mitt Romney had Paul Ryan. And D's Nuts has Limber Butt McCubbins.
Meow is the time.
Brady hopes his campaign will make it easier for third parties to gain some power in the future because even if he does win by some miracle, he's about 20 years too young to legally be named president.
Ageism. What? Yes, I am right.
And finally, it is the best Twitter account in the world, Ice's Karaoke. President Obama has long been saying that he has plans to
degrade and ultimately destroy the terrorist group known as ISIL.
But it looks like the first part is already taken care of.
I like big butts and I cannot lie. You other brothers can't deny.
The account does exactly what you'd expect. It takes photos of ISIL members and then matches them with all your favourite karaoke songs.
She called me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic, touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Rowe.
Which is great because it just humanises them. I mean, we all speak the language of music. Take it away, Captain Hook.
Once upon a time I was falling in love, but now I'm only falling apart.